Oh, I hope it goes okay. Hey! Frankie! It's been about 6-7 hours today just to get it. This is not for the faint of heart, but I am so thrilled. Sonya's at the hotel, so now I gotta have my first experience driving in Colombia alone.
This is my first time seeing Frank. You know, Dakota got the truck yesterday. We essentially just parked it. We were so happy to have the truck, but this morning, like I said, we wanted to come down,
try to get organized.
And what we find is that customs and border control, they went through everything. They took everything out of the attic. Some of the bags that we had things organized, they're not, stuff isn't, you know, like we left it. We couldn't find a flashlight, so we had to go through the camping bag to find a flashlight so we can actually see better inside the truck. But this is a mess.
Yeah, it's a mess.
So we'll take a few pictures so y'all can kind of see. And like, they even took the towel out of the little bag that it was in. But it's all good. It's all good. We'll get it together. But just know that
I'm sure they got to do the, they're looking for contraband, drugs, any of that stuff. We get it. We understand.
And so, yeah, and we expected them to go through, but we didn't have the expectation that everything that we spent so long organizing would not be organized anymore. So
yeah, and some stuff is missing. We still ain't been able to find everything.
Well, you know, I honestly think that once we go through everything,
it'll be there.
Yeah, I think everything will be here. Yeah. It just won't be where we thought it was. Because I mean, just think about it. You take some stuff out. If you didn't organize it and you try to put something back the way someone else had it, unless you have a system, which clearly they didn't, not, something's gonna get missed and not put back. And I think at a certain point, it was just like, you know what, just throw it all in the damn truck and it'll be fine. But this shit is for the birds.
Long story short, we got jacked. That's all it is to be said. So now we're gonna go meet up with our group. Look at this, look at this. Sir, what do you have?
I have a little soup.
A little.
Kind of like a seafood
dumpling. You gotta put the hand in there so you can get the reference.
See how big it is.
That's a fish.
Big fish, this is a shark.
Big fish.
I think once we get the flow going and understanding how each handles the situation, we kind of get into a good working environment of all the different teams and the people.
And the way we do it, are we following each other? Okay. So
we just realized that this will be our first time having our feet in the water
on a South American beach, touching the Atlantic Ocean.
Let's do it. These are the moments that we come here for. Who doesn't love to see a beautiful sunset, walking on a beach, holding hands with the woman that you love, reflecting on everything that you saw in the city? But we knew we had a long day ahead of us. Sonya wanted to look at the maps. We also needed to pack the truck. So back to the hotel to do all of that before we get started. So just had breakfast with Sonya. We now have to run in town to get insurance for the truck. So I'm meeting Frank from Land Cruiser Heaven down there to get insurance for Frank, the tank. And we should be able to start the expedition. Because we didn't have all of the paperwork together before we headed out Friday or Saturday, you can't drive in Colombia without insurance. So we gotta make sure that we get it and we'll be able to move on. And I know somebody's out there like, wait a minute, there's some funniness about how'd you get your truck out of port without having insurance? We don't ask questions, but we were able to get the truck out of port without insurance, but now we have to get it. So the morning starts at 7:30 and we're on the run. I must say, the hardest part of this whole thing was finding the place. After that, file the insurance paperwork, make the payment, wait about 10 minutes for them to generate it, and boom, there's your insurance. And I was off, heading back to the hotel to meet up with Sonya and the rest of the team.
So get ready to put the sticker on. This way everybody be able to communicate on the team. We all know who each other are. And we can identify each other with the trucks. So let's take a look at what that looks like.
At this point, I can honestly say the excitement started to build in. Everybody was getting their number decals put on their trucks. We were staged in front of the hotel, so everybody was looking at us, put all of the gear inside of the truck. I'm sure we were quite the spectacle. But when it was all said and done, we all felt like we were starting to gel as a team.
So now we have to do some videos, sort of like an intro to everybody on the team. You see we got on our shirts. Yeah. Team Land Cruiser Heaven. And eventually at some point we're gonna be we're gonna participate in a race. So right now we're just doing introductions for the whole team. We're gonna be the last ones to go and then we'll get ready to head out.
Before we set off, we couldn't resist taking some epic photos on the beach. How often do you get to ship your truck to another country, drive out on the beach, and take pictures? Nakota, of course, had to talk to a few locals, and then we were off on our journey. But, of course, we couldn't leave without getting gas. And when I tell you, the fill up on this tank was crazy. It was the first time we had the auxiliary tank, and it was about $100. Join us next week on Staples and Tents as we continue our journey onto Colombia. As you can see already, the landscape is beautiful and we have so much more to see. We've just gotten started. Thanks for watching. As always, make sure you give the video a thumbs up.
Subscribe!
Subscribe and tell a friend.